After 5 years since the announcement, Bethesda Studios' newest RPG Starfield is finally here, and this time under the umbrella of Microsoft as an Xbox and PC exclusive. The game is developed using the newest in-house creation engine 2, and most of the time the game can showcase remarkable visuals. However, performance-wise it's not perfect, and it's one of the most demanding games this year. That's why in this video we'll benchmark and compare each graphical setting in order to determine the optimal combination that should give us the best balance between good visuals and performance. So without any further ado, let's get going. But before that, a quick word from today's sponsor GVG Mall, an online store for games, keys, office and Windows licenses. GVG Mall is celebrating the back to school season with a special 25% discount code BK25 for the Windows 10 Pro key. Simply click on buy now, create an account and subscribe to their email offers for extra benefits. And during checkout, apply code BK25 to reduce the Windows key price to just $16. And after payment, you'll find your key on your order page, which you can use to activate your Windows 10. Plus, if you wish to upgrade to Windows 11 later, it's free. And if you already have Windows 11 Pro, you can still use the BK25 code for a 25% discount. So check the links in the description below, use code BK25 and get activated today. And big thanks to GVG Mall for sponsoring this video. Before we dive in into the comparisons, first I want to discuss the game's presentation and the visuals on display. Starfield most of the time looks excellent, particularly in terms of its intricate details and the high quality of different materials. In addition to its high quality global illumination, particularly evident in indoor environments. However, because of the vast scope of the game, not every area maintains the same level of visual excellence. For instance, water looks mediocre as the game exclusively relies on cube maps for reflections, with no SSR or RT reflections. Also, similar to many other Bethesda games, characters and NPCs don't look great. And when it comes to the graphics menu, the game doesn't offer anything special. There are no preview images that showcase the visual impact of each setting, and the description doesn't provide any helpful information. Also, the amount of tweakable settings is limited in number, lacking basic settings like texture quality, texture filtering and FOV. And for upscaling instead of presets and quality options, the game offers a resolution scaling slider, and I really like this approach as it gives more customization and control to the user. And unfortunately, there is no official support for DLSS or DLAA. FSR2 is the only upscaler here. However, there is a mod that swaps FSR2 with DLSS. And while FSR2 can give much clearer image compared to native TAA and can preserve fine details much better, it has some noticeable issues like shimmering even at 100% resolution scaling. FSR2 looks unstable compared to TAA. And when adding the DLSS mod to the comparison, we can clearly see that DLSS greatly improved the image stability and has less shimmering even when compared to native TAA. DLSS can also fix ghost scenes that appear on some animated signs like here. And if you have an RTX GPU, I highly recommend using the DLSS mod as it can allow you to drop the resolution scaling even further compared to FSR2, which should give higher performance while maintaining better image quality. Now let's kick off with shadow quality. This one adjusts the resolution and quality of shadows like here, and also affect shadows draw distance. And the performance impact of this setting can vary depending on the location. For example, here in New Atlantis, going from low to medium and high costs around 3% and to ultra 9%. But in other areas like this forest with a lot of shadow casting objects, the performance impact is much bigger. Here going from low to medium and high costs 11% and to ultra a massive 27%. So here for shadows, I recommend medium or high. Next we have indirect lighting. At first glance, I thought that this setting will affect the quality of global illumination, but going back and forth between low and ultra doesn't show any visual difference. And strangely enough, I I've noticed that the setting in some areas can affect the rendering resolution of some distant objects, like here. And performance-wise, going from low to medium and beyond can cost 4%. So for better image stability, I recommend medium and direct lighting. Reflection is next, and this setting controls the quality of cube maps used for reflections. And performance-wise, going from low to medium costs around 1% and to high 5%. So here I recommend medium reflections. Particle quality, similar to indirect lighting, has no significant visual impact. And I've tested this setting in several places, but I couldn't notice any visual difference. And on the performance side, in most areas, it has negligible performance impact. However, in some areas like here, with this weird looking mist effect at the bottom of New Atlantis waterfall, using high or medium can cost up to 16% compared to low. And the same thing here in Neon City. We can see that going from low to medium and high costs around 15% with no noticeable visual improvements. So here I recommend low particle quality. Next we have volumetric lighting, which should control the quality of volumetric effects. But similar to particle quality, it's really hard to notice any visual difference between these setting options. And on the performance side, it's one of the most demanding settings in this game. For example, here with this foggy weather, going from low to medium costs 9%, to high and ultra a massive 23%. So here for my optimized settings, I recommend low volumetric lighting. Moving on to crowd density, this setting adjusts the number of NPCs and it's more noticeable in big cities like Neon here. And performance wise, when GPU bound, going from low to even high costs around 3%. However, when CPU bound, going from low to medium costs 4%, and to high 13%. So here I recommend low or medium crowd density, especially if you have a weaker CPU. For ambient occlusion, Starfield relies on GTAO, and here we can see that higher options improve the intensity of ambient occlusion. And it's worth noting that in certain areas like here, using anything but ultra can result in noticeable noise around corners. And on the performance side, GTAO is so cheap to use, as going from low to even ultra costs around 2%. So here I recommend ultra GTAO. Next we have grass quality, and this one mainly controls the draw distance of foliage like here. And performance wise, going from low to medium costs 2%, and to high and ultra 6%. So for my optimized settings, I recommend medium grass quality. Moving on to contact shadows, this setting, from what I have seen, only has noticeable visual impact on weapons, where with medium, high and ultra, we can see that this weapon can cast some surf shadows, unlike low. And visually, medium, high and ultra look similar. And this setting has negligible performance impact. So for this one, I recommend medium. Starfield supports variable ray shading or VRS, but the implementation is not great. In most instances, I couldn't notice any visual or performance difference when toggling this setting on or off. The only place where VRS makes a difference on the performance side is near transparent surfaces like here, where I saw around 6% performance gain. Therefore, I recommend keeping VRS on. It doesn't affect the visuals, and it might give you some extra performance in some areas. And finally, we have depth of field, which appears to have minimal impact on the performance, whether during conversations like here or during gameplay. So if you like this effect, don't worry about the performance and keep it on. And based on everything we saw so far, these are my recommended settings. Let's now compare optimized settings and ultra preset using DLSS mod at 67% resolution scaling on both sides, which correspond to DLSS quality mode. Let's start with New Atlantis. We can see here that optimized settings can offer around 40% more FPS compared to ultra preset. Next, we have this area near New Atlantis, which has a lot of foliage and trees. And here we can see around 37% more FPS with optimized settings compared to ultra preset. And finally, we have Neon City. And here we can see the biggest difference with 49% boost to performance when going from ultra preset to optimized settings. Overall, Starfield is a mixed bag. The game often exhibits impressive visuals, but in my opinion, the visuals on display don't justify the performance. And the game could have greatly benefited from more optimization prior to its release. And we can only hope that after the official launch, Bethesda will keep working on improving the game's performance and add official support for DLSS and XeSS. And that's it for this one. I hope this video helped you and provided you with some useful information. Thank you so much for watching and for your time. If you enjoyed the video, leave a like, and if not, leave a dislike. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell for future videos, and hopefully I'll see you all in the next one.